On Passive VR, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use custom avatars in InstantVR. Well, you already know that the InstantVR comes with a standard first-person avatar, but this one already has a nifty feature hidden inside. Actually, I'm doing everything in this video with InstantVR Advanced, but you can do the same in the free version of InstantVR, because the avatar is almost the same. Well, in this video I'm using Rift plus Leap Motion with the Orion support, of course. And a lot of people with the Rift or the Leap Motion just want floating hands. But when you go to the first person avatar and you look at it, then you see there's a number of meshes inside. And actually, when you disable the shoes, the jeans and the shirt, or the mesh renderer or the game object itself, you're just left with two floating hands. So that's already fulfilling the need for having separate meshes for floating hands. Actually, you can just, if you want, you can just remove those meshes. There's a warning, but you can ignore that. And now, when I press play, I will actually have two floating hands with Leap Motion. So that's the first step. But having a different avatar is more interesting, of course. So when you look at the package itself, you already may have noticed that there is a characters folder inside. And it has a Make Human Rig folder, which contains actually two avatars. The first one is the familiar first-person avatar. And the second one is a third-person avatar with head, with a back. And so in some cases this may be more convenient. So what we are going to do is replace the standard first person avatar, which is now just reduced to the hands, by the third person avatar. So how do we do this? We go to the InstantVR game object and we select the game object with the animator, the avatar itself, the mesh. And now we just press delete to remove the avatar. So now we're actually left with just the targets and the main scripts. Now we pick up the third person avatar, you can see it, and we drag it on top of the InstantVR script. And you can already see it's not in teach pose anymore, it already has taken over the avatar. And when you press play, it should move with my hands, and there's the other one too. So that's basically it. It's just replacing the avatar inside InstantVR. However, in practice you will see that things get a bit more difficult, because not all avatars are configured in the same way. So I will show you a number of other examples. And for that we go to the Asset Store, and I have pre-downloaded Robert Kyle. Space Robot Kyle. It's a very familiar one. It's used in a lot of demos. So I'm going to show you how to use Space Robot Kyle in InstantVR. So for this one, we're going to import Kyle into our project. And here we have Robot Kyle. There's the model in here. You have it. So that's nice, but we want to use it for our setup. So now we go back to our InstantVR object. We remove the third person now, and we just want to drop Robot Kyle to this place. And, well, actually it's still in the default position. And when I press play, you will notice that, oh, there's a lot of things going on. It's not working. Why is that? Why isn't it working? Well, first of all, Robot Kyle is not, it's quite an old avatar. And actually the rig is of the type legacy. So when we go to the model and we look at the rig, it says animation type legacy. That's the old one, legacy, it says it all. So we have changed that into humanoid and press apply. Oh, you see already it's changing. Just get rid of all the errors. And, well, just let's check. Does it work already? Aha! Okay, it is moving, but something is off. The head is going well, but the hands are also there. You can see them. Those are my hands. But the arms are doing strange things. So why is that? Now, the problem with Robot Kyle is it's not in T-pose. So InstantVR needs the avatar in T-pose. And actually, there's a very nifty trick to get any avatar in T-pose. And I will show you that. So I remove this one and we select Robot Kyle again with the humanoid rig and we go to configure. Yeah, we do want to save it for now. In configure, you can configure which limbs, which bones are actually which limbs. We don't need to do that because Robot Kyle is configured very well. But the interesting thing we see now, at the right, Robot Kyle is actually in T-pose now. And that is what we are going to use this time. So we go back, we go to the hierarchy. Here we have Robot Kyle clone. And I will rename that to Robot Kyle T-pose. And now I drag this Robot Kyle T-pose to my project. And I put it next to Robot Kyle itself. So now I have two Robot Kyles, T-pose and non-T-pose. So when I go back to my scene, and this is the normal one, and now I also have, hey, my T-pose Kyle. I can remove the two again. And now I remove Robot Kyle normal and insert the T-pose Kyle. Hey! It's already looking better. The arms are a bit longer than the default avatar, so now they are curled up. But actually, you can see now Robot Kyle is following exactly my movements. So I'm happy. Robot Kyle is mine. I'm Robot Kyle right now. Okay, so that's one thing. Things can get a bit more hairy. And for this, we go to another asset store favorite of mine, which is the zombie. Here we have zombie draft. It's also a free asset in the asset store. And I'm going to import that one too in my package. It's a bit more complex because it has a lot of the animations. And let's see where it is. Zombie, here it is. And we are looking for the model. And actually we have five models, or it seems to be, but most of them are just animations. And just the zombie walk has the mesh itself. But you can already see, ha, it's not in T-pose. Actually, it's worse than that. When we go to the model and we go to the rig, it says animation times is not legacy, it's generic. Still, we can try to put it on humanoid. Apply. Hey, and it succeeds. So if it doesn't succeed, you're maybe able to assign all the bones yourself in this. I have to make some more space. In this overview, we can just say for every bone, which one is it. So I have the left upper arm, which is actually in the bone hierarchy, this one, which is the right one. But I could also change, what can we do? Change the spine. So this is not the spine one I want, but this one. And now you can see that the spine is not spine 1 anymore, but just a normal spine. Actually, I don't know what happens when I leave it like that. So I leave it at spine 1. But here you can reconfigure yourself which bones match to the right parts of the body. Again, we saw that the avatar was not in T-pose. Now here we have a T-pose of the zombie, so we will just rename this to zombie T-pose, and that is what we're going to use as our model. So now we're dragging the zombie T-pose here, or here, and here we have our zombie we want. Done. No, just revert. So this is the default zombie, and here we have him in T-pose. Nicely posed. Okay. Go back to our InstantVR object. Remove Robot Kyle. He's done a good job. Okay, and we import the zombie. And there he is. Looking stiff. Okay, let's play. Hey, it's moving already. One thing you will notice, the fingers are not moving. And that's correct, because this one, this avatar, hey, hello, somehow, yeah, it's gone again. Somehow this avatar doesn't have finger bones. We can show it when we go to this one and configure the rig. If you go to the hands, they are gray already, but when you look at the hands themselves, there are no bones assigned to the fingers. And when you look at the avatar, you just see, well, the arms, nothing more. So this one doesn't have any fingers. So when you use the leap motion with this model, the fingers cannot move. So should be clear. Another one is, you will see that the camera is not aligned to the head right now, but that can be solved quite easily. When just select the InstantVR script, it will realign the camera to the eyes of the avatar. So now everything should be okay. Hey. Another thing, you will see I have floating hands. Well, in the middle view I have floating hands and no arms. Although you can see here the arms are there, but they're not rendered. That's a thing we can solve quite easily, but you now have to know that. We go to the zombie and just go to the arms, or actually you can do it for all parts, but we show it for the arms, just the forearms in this case, and we need to select update when off screen. When we update this one, you will see that it will render the arms again. So now it looks better. It may also happen with the upper arm, so you may also need to, well, it doesn't happen this time. I don't know exactly what the reason for it is. So you may also need to select the same checkbox for the upper arms, update when off screen. Okay, so that's basically it. If you have problems with other avatars and they look right to you, just contact me and I will look into it, because usually it should be possible to use any kinds of avatars. I hope you will make great things with this, and looking forward to see your results. Okay, thank you and see you in the next video. Bye.